This is the layout of the apartment unit, which has a small bedroom and one master bedroom. And this is the living room area. So now we are going to start drafting and designing the air conditioning system for this living room. The apartment unit will be provided with a fan coil unit, split type, ceiling mounted, and ducted type. So the ceiling height for this apartment unit living room area is about 2,800 mm or 2.8 meters, and the ceiling height for the toilet area is 2.5 meters. So we are going to place the fan coil unit above the toilet area and then provide the layout for the supply air duals in the living room. Now we go to system, mechanical equipment, and I have already preloaded the fan coil unit family. If you haven't loaded up your family, you can go to insert, load family, and go to the relevant project or folder location. Now we have to set the elevation of the fan coil unit in respect to the floor level, which is level 1. So here we need to set 2 meters, click apply, and click on the location for the fan coil. To check if we have the correct elevation, you can go to the view section, create a section, click the arrow, and then from here, the section, you can see that the fan coil unit is above the ceiling level of the tower. Now we have to go back to level 1 program. The erase, we need to erase first the section so we clear the drafting area. Now we have to lay out all the supply air drills and return air drills for this living room area. So in order to do that, we have to go to the system, air terminal, and 2-slot linear diffuser. So this is the supply air drill or supply diffuser. I'm going to place it equally, 3 numbers, distribute the cool air accordingly. On the opposite side, we also need to have the return air for the air to flow from one side to the other side. You can have it at the same location so it's aesthetically nice for the ceiling. So now we have already placed the supply air drill, and then this is the return air drill. Now we will proceed to draw the supply air duct and return air duct layout. So we have to go to system duct, and we'll be using a rectangular duct for this exercise. You can set here the type of fittings that you would like to use or you prefer to use by clicking the edit, select the routing preferences, and you can see that there are different types of fittings you can use. I have already set it to my preferred fittings, so I will leave it as it is. Another thing to check is your system classification under mechanical. It should be supply air, and the system side should be supply air. So basically we're working on the supply air duct, so this will be supply air. So here on the top you can set the duct width and the duct height. So for here we can use 200 and 200. The next is the middle elevation. This is the elevation of the duct at the center of the duct in reference to the floor level. So basically our ceiling is 3.8, so we can set it around 3.2. click apply, then you can draw the deck. From here we have to increase the deck size to 300 by 200, maintaining the elevation, and then click apply. We have to do it again, that works, 300, maintain the elevation, apply, and then click connect till the center line, then turn. This will be around 400 by 200. So now we go to here. Then connect to the fan coil unit. So the as you click it to the end of the fan coil unit, there is a duct connector here which connects it automatically from the FCU connector to the supplier air duct. So now we have to go again from the supplier, connect to this main duct. So we have to go duct rectangular, set the size 200 by 200, maintain the elevation, select the point, and then connect to the side of the duct. Now we have to connect this branch duct to this main duct. Just select the branch duct. The point will appear. Just drag it into the edge of the main duct, and then the correct type of fittings that you have set in the edit and duct routing preferences will come out. It will connect automatically to the main duct. The next step is to connect the grills to the main duct using a flexible duct. So click flexible. You can set the diameter. For me, I'm going to use 200. Here the elevation you can maintain it as it is, as once you have selected the deck, it will automatically inherit the elevation of this deck. So click here and then click on the grill. Now the system is attached the grill to the branch deck or the main deck. The next is we need to provide a tap for the flexible deck to connect from the grill to the main deck. We go to that round duct tap, then we can set 200 and then the elevation here. Then we can use the flexible duct to connect the grill to the main duct. Flexible. The last one is we can straight away use a flexible duct from the end of the duct, then select the grill connector. Now as you can see, all the grills has turned blue. It means that these grills are connected to the system of the supply. Now we'll proceed with the layout of the return air duct. So in order to do that, we have to select that. Make sure that we set the system type to return air duct. So it automatically also changes the system classifications to the return air. And you will notice it later that the color of the return air duct will be different from the supply air duct. So now we go to the system duct, rectangular duct. Make sure the size is 200 by 200, 300, and the elevation is 3.2 meters. So we start from the end. See, we need to change this to 300 by 200. Then we turn. Now we have to change the duct size to 400 by 200. So go further. The turn air duct is always connected at the back of the fan coil unit. So we have to turn here and then connect directly to the fan coil. So now as you can see, the color is magenta or pink, this red color represents the return air duct. Now we'll continue in connecting the return air wheels to the return air duct using the same concept, flexible duct. Make sure that your system type is set to return air, and then the diameter is 200. Click the duct connector from the grid, and then the end of the duct. Now I think we haven't set the correct elevation for the grill, so we need to click the grill and then set the elevation to 2000 feet. You can see the flexible duct has automatically updated. And also we need to change these two grills to fit it. So now same thing on this return air duct, we need to have a round tap connector for the flexible to connect from the grill to the main duct. So we go to system, duct, round taps, set it at same level, which is 3200. The diameter should be 200. Apply and draw the duct tap round connector. Now we will connect with a flexible duct. Check return air diameter. Click it. So now, as you can see, the color of the grill has also changed. It means it is connected to the return air duct system. Here we also need a round duct tap connector, so we have to go to system duct, round tap 200, then click on the location you prefer, stretch, then click select twice or escape twice. Then use a flexible deck to connect the grill to the main deck. So now, okay, I think we still have an elevation not set, so we have to set it to 2000. Click apply, as you can see it automatically updated. Now you have completed the design for a simple air conditioning system with the supply air duct and return air duct. So hope this will help for you to start working on your EZMB design air conditioning system in 3D. Thank you.